Good morning students, welcome to the JMPS online classes. Today I am going to start a new chapter of the maths, that is division. As you all know, we have already studied about the multiplication, isn't it? What is multiplication? Multiplication is a repeated addition, isn't it? But division, it is just reverse of multiplication. See, relation between multiplication and division. Multiplication and divisions are inverse operation. What do you mean by inverse? Inverse means opposite. Ek dusre ke ulta, opposite. Is it clear? So, for every multiplication fact, we have two division facts. Jab bhi hum koi bhi cheeze multiply karte hain, when we will do a multiplication thing, we get two factors. Isn't it? 4, 3, these are what? These are factors. And 12 is the product. 4 multiplied by 3, we get 12. 4 3s are 12. So 4 and 3, here it is a factor, but 12 is a product. See, this product can be divided by its factor. अब हमें इसको divide करने के लिए क्या करना होगा? जो इनके factors होते हैं, उनको आपस से divide करना होगा. 12 divided by 4, we get 3. 12 divided by 3, we get 4. So this is what? This is an inverse or opposite reaction, isn't it? When we multiply two factors, we get product. When we divide product by factors, we get another factor. This is the basic concept or the relation of multiplication and division. Suppose I have taken any two examples. 3 multiplied by 3, what we get? 9. But 9 divided by 3, we get 3. Or 9 divided by another factor, that is 3, we get 3. So, multiplication and division are the inverse related factors. When we add the same things again and again, repeated addition is known as multiplication. When we divide, we get subtraction digits. For example, here is a form of division. I have taken one very simple division for you all. 8 divided by 2, we get 4. Why we get 4? Because 2 multiplied by 4, we get 8. 2 4 sa 8 hota hai. Agar 8 ko hum uske factors se divide karenge, that is 2 se divide karenge, we get 4. Agar 8 ko hum 4 se divide karenge, then we get 2. So when we divide the product by its factors, we get another factor. See, the number which is divided by another number. Here this one is called, 2 is called divisor. 8 is called quotient. 4 is called dividend. And when we get here cross or 0, we get remainder as it is. See, this is the whole chart I have written for you all. Please go through this chart, because this is very important to know the factors and its product. 2 is called divisor, 8 is called quotient, 4 is called dividend, and if we get the remainder, agar hume remainder milta hai, then we get 0. We revise once again the whole thing which we have studied. First, we have studied about the relation between multiplication and division. Division is a very important and basic concept in math. You have to know how to divide any number. But before dividing any number, we should know the relation between multiplication and division. Because multiplication and division is the inverse relation, has its inverse relation, the opposite relation. Ek dusre se kya hote hai? Ulte hote. Suppose multiplication, as I told you all, it is a repeated addition. But division is the form of subtraction. Multiplication and division are inverse operations. For every multiplication fact, we have two division facts. Kabhi bhi hum log, jab bhi number ko divide karte hain, to hum log ko kya milta hai? Two division facts milte hain. Like 12 divided by 3, we get 4. 12 divided by 4, we get 3. Is it clear? These are what? These are two multiplication facts. Come to here, we have done one division. We should know what are the quotient, what are the dividend, what are the divisor, and what are the remainders. So, here the number through which we divide the product is called divisor. The number which is actually divided, jisko hum divide karte hain, that is called quotient. And the answer we get after dividing, we get dividend. 0, 1, whatever, it will call as remainder.
पॉज करना था,
हम मर्ज कर देंगे, कितना मिनट का हुआ ये बता।
Now come to the next topic, that is properties of division. In this we will learn three properties. First is, when a number is divided by 1, we get the same number. For example, 7 divided by 1, we get the quotient same. 5 divided by 1, we get the quotient same. In this property, we will see कि कोई भी number अगर हम 1 से divide करेंगे, तो जो quotient आएगा, हमारा जो यहाँ पर quotient आएगा, वो क्या है? Same number, isn't it? 7 divided by 1, we get 7. 7 हमारा क्या है? Same number आया. 5 divided by 1, we get 5. Here also, क्या है? Same number. So, this is the first property, that whenever we divide any number by 1, we get quotient as same number. Next is, next property, when a number is divided by itself, we get 1 as a quotient. जब भी कोई number खुद से divide होता है, same number से divide होता है, तो हमें quotient क्या मिलता है? 1 मिलता है. For example, 8 is divided by 8, we get 1. Here, 9 divided by 9, we get 1. So, this two same numbers means खुद से, itself से divide करेगा, तो quotient क्या आएगा? 1. Here also, 9 divided by 9, we get 1. So, quotient will be same. Come to the third property. Third property is, when we divide 0 by any number, किसी भी number को हम अगर 0 से divide करते हैं, then we get 0 as a quotient. हमें quotient क्या मिलता है? 0 मिलता है. For example, 0 divided by 6, we get 0. 0 divided by 3, we get 0. So, we have learned three properties. What are the three properties we have learned? First, when a number is divided by 1. जब भी कोई number 1 से divide करेंगे, then what we get? We get quotient as same number. Same number हमें quotient मिलेगा. Second, when a number is divided by itself, जब वो खुद से divide करेगा, तो हमें क्या मिलेगा? Quotient 1 मिलेगा. Suppose 8 divided by 8, we get 1. 9 divided by 9, we get 1. And the last we have learned, when we divide 0, when we divide any number by 0, so we get the number or the quotient as 0. For example, 0 divided by 6, we get 0. 0 divided by 3, we get 0. So today we have learned three major topics. First, we have learned the relation between multiplication and division. Second, we have learned about the divisor, dividend, quotient and remainder. And the third, we have learned about the properties of division. Please go through the chapter once again. If you have any doubt, we will discuss in the live session. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.